numbers. So there are two different types of numbers we're going to talk about today, but all of these numbers are part of the real numbers. Now, in the real numbers, you have rational numbers and you have irrational numbers. The rational numbers are being represented by Iron Man and his team in Captain America: Civil War. And the irrational numbers are being represented by Captain America. The reason why I chose Iron Man is not just because I'm a Marvel fan, but because Iron Man is rational in his decisions in the movie, I think so. And Captain America is irrational in his decisions in the movie. So that's why the teams are why they are right now. Let's start with the rational man, Mr. Iron Man. So rational numbers contain integers represented by War Machine, the whole numbers represented by Black Panther, the counting numbers, or some people call them natural numbers, represented by Black Widow, and an example would be the number one, represented by Vision. Now, the number one, most famous number in my opinion, because everybody wants to be number one. The number one is an example of a counting number. So I'm gonna put number one inside of the counting numbers. The counting numbers are numbers you count with, like 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. But notice when you're counting, you don't start with zero. If you're playing hide and seek, you don't go 0, 1. No, you start at one. But if you want to include zero, it now becomes a whole number. So inside of the whole numbers are the counting numbers and zero. So the counting numbers do not have zero, but the whole numbers do. So whole numbers are zero plus the counting numbers. Next, we have the integers. Well, the integers are the positive numbers, like the counting numbers, and they're the negative numbers and zero. Positive, negative, and zero. So the whole numbers fit inside of the integers, but I'm also including the negative numbers. So integers are the whole numbers plus the negative numbers. Finally, we're dealing with rational numbers as a whole. Well, all of these numbers are rational, but also fractions and decimals that end and repeat. What do I mean by that? Well, the integers do fit inside the rational numbers, but they also include fractions. So fractions like 2/3 or 1/3 or, I don't know, 8/15, all those fractions are considered to be rational because those fractions end and they might repeat. What do I mean by end? Well, 3/4 is 0.75 and it's done, it ends. 1/3 is 0.33333333. It doesn't end, but the same number repeats over and over again. That is still okay to be a rational number. Any number that can be written as a fraction is rational and is part of Iron Man's team. Now let's talk about the irrational people over here. So Captain America, he's an irrational number in this example. And irrational numbers, they have a lot of different components to them, but they cannot be rational. They're not a part of the same team. So, non-terminating decimals that do not repeat, represented here by the Falcon, are irrational. So like the most famous irrational number is pi, represented here by the Winter Soldier. So pi would consider to be irrational because it never ends. In fact, it's famous for never ending, and all the numbers are different, so they do not repeat. So non-terminating, which means it doesn't end, non-repeating, like pi, numbers are considered to be irrational. Two other examples that are also irrational. It would be like the square root of 3 and the square root of 2. When you put those in the calculator, they never end and they also do not repeat. If you notice, I made sure they were all separate. They weren't nested because these are all examples. One doesn't fit into the other like this does. It's kind of irrational. And these are all real numbers. So it's kind of like the Marvel universe is like the real number universe. Hope you took notes. See you later.